हेलो हेलो हेलो, वेलकम एवरीवन टू दिस न्यू स्ट्रीम ऑफ चेस बेस इंडिया एंड द टाइटल ऑफ इट इज मैच. वेल, द आइडिया इज दैट वी आर ब्रिंगिंग फोर्थ टू रियली वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्फियर्स. वन इज मैथ्स, द अदर वन इज चेस. एंड व्हेन यू काइंड ऑफ मर्ज द टू, इट्स कॉल्ड मैच. एंड ऑन योर स्क्रीन यू कैन सी इन द सेंटर इज अ जीनियस. हिज नेम इज भानु, नीलकंठ भानु. एंड ही इज अ वर्ल्ड चैम्पियन इन मेंटल कैलकुलेशन. यू गोइंग टू नो मोर अबाउट हिम. एंड हिज एम इज दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल इन द वर्ल्ड शुड लर्न अबाउट मैथ्स एंड नॉट बी अफ्रेड ऑफ इट. वाइल द मैन ऑन द लेफ्ट, हिज एम इज दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल इन द वर्ल्ड शुड लर्न अबाउट चेस. सो वी थॉट वाई नॉट कम टुगेदर. एंड द मैन ऑन द राइट, who is very very intelligent, his aim is to do, you know, he's good at both maths and chess, so that's why we have him today over here. So let me first check how is everyone doing in the chat. It's a very it's going to be great fun, guys. Someone writes maths plus chess equals mess. Okay, that was also one way of looking at it, although I made it as match. And let me, without any delay, welcome the man of the moment over here, Nilkanth. Hello,
Hello.
Nilkanth. Ah, now I can
Hi.
hear you. Oh, you had muted yourself. How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. How are you, Sagar? I'm great.
Excellent, excellent. I am great, and so nice to have you. This is the first. Oh, and we also have Mr.
Hello.
Biswa Kalyan Rath here.
Hello. How
Hello,
are you guys?
Biswa. How are you doing?
I'm very good. Can you guys hear me?
Very well.
Yes,
Okay,
yes.
awesome. Hi, Nilkant. Very nice to meet you.
Thank you. Very nice to meet you too. Hi.
Awesome, buddy. Hello. Very excited.
Biswa, I was
Who am
telling
I? Who am I?
the chat that there is
Oh, we are live
someone.
already.
Yes.
Give me warning.
But today you were so nice, you didn't say anything like 30 हो गया, ये हो गया, वो हो गया, nothing. You are like, hello,
What's about to
Nilkanth.
say?
So here is me, who is like chess में, बचपन से I'm doing chess. Nilkanth is here, who is बचपन से doing maths, and you are there, who is doing maths and chess both. So we thought like बहुत ही मजेदार combination.
Yes, I have one problem because maths plus chess is mess or chhat. It's not match. Okay, whoever has.
छत
आई वॉज ट्राइंग टू
छत
मेक छत, बट आई डिडंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इट, सो मैच कर दिया.
या
तो भी यार
दैट्स
मतलब
नॉट करेक्ट.
बट नीलकंठ, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेल अस अ बिट अबाउट योर सेल्फ, बिकॉज यू आर अ वर्ल्ड चैंपियन इन मेंटल कैलकुलेशन. एंड हाउ डज दैट, एंड यू आर ऑल्सो लाइक नोन एज द ह्यूमन कैलक्यूलेटर. एंड पीपल हैव ड्रॉन पैरेलल्स बिटवीन यू एंड लेट्स से द ग्रेटेस्ट मैथमेटिशियंस और यू नो कैलक्यूलेटर्स लाइक शकुंतला देवी एंड ऑल ऑफ दीज वेल नोन पर्सनैलिटीज. सो टेल अस अ बिट अबाउट योर सेल्फ. यूर एंड यू आर ओनली 20 ईयर्स ओल्ड.
21, या 21,
21.
यस. हाँ, तो मैं आई एज यू मेंशन्ड, आई होल्ड अ फ्यू वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड्स जो मेंटल कैलकुलेशन में है. आई एम अदरवाइज लेट्स से अ मैथ एकेडमिक. आई हैव ग्रेजुएटेड रिसेंटली इन मैथ, बट अदरवाइज एज यू मेंशन्ड, देयर बीन सेवरल ग्रेट्स इन द फील्ड ऑफ मेंटल कैलकुलेशन एज अ स्पॉट पर से, इवन फ्रॉम इंडिया, विच इज शकुंतला देवी जी एंड अ फ्यू अदर पीपल लाइक स्कॉट फ्लांसर. बहुत लोग हैं. आई इन द लास्ट फ्यू ईयर्स, आई मीन ever since I was a child, I actually loved math, absolutely. And mental math was one thing which I picked on, saying that it's about solving puzzles, it's about optimizing your brain, it's about developing and sprinting. So it was something which was very interesting. So I picked that up as something which I wanted to pursue. And few years down the line, when it comes to today, I hold four world records,
Four world
50
records.
and 50 LIMCA records, and I've recently won
50, what? 50?
50, 50. Yes.
How do you
Yeah.
achieve 50 record? I'm thinking right now to make one record. How to achieve it?
तो
You've made
मेंटल कैलकुलेशन,
50.
या मेंटल कैलकुलेशन में जैसे क्रिकेट में होती है ना, हर जगह एक एक के लिए एक एक रिकॉर्ड, तो अच्छा ही है. इट्स अ गुड गुड पिक, एक ही बार में बाउंस
विश्वा
हुई.
यस, 50 लिम्का रिकॉर्ड्स.
Yeah. No, I was listening. The bell rang, so I had to run, but I had my headphones on, so I heard everything.
And
that's amazing, man.
Thank you. And I've recently won the Mind Sports Olympics at London for, let's say, being quicker than anyone else. I hold a few records, which are once held by Shakuntala Devi herself. So yeah.
Wow.
Pretty fun.
Wow. You know, first time Neelkanth called me, few days ago, I had seen Shakuntala Devi movie. And in that, she used to go to different places and do these shows related to maths and showcase her talent. And then when he called me, I said, do you do something similar? And he said, yes, and also no, because there are a lot of other things that you do and you are more like trying to promote mental maths. And now you want to make sure that people are not afraid of mathematics.
Ha. So basically, एक बात है कि a lot of people think mental calculation बोले तो even if I was actually browsing through the live chat अभी right now a little while ago ये Vedic math है या ये Abacus है ये जो चीज़ होती है ना तो that all is I think the general mistake which we have towards this as a sport क्योंकि ना एक trick बना के छोटा optimize करके you do as a solution I think mental calculation is more like running where there is no other way अगर तूने skate कर दिया तो skating हो गया वो it's not running anymore So, whatever calculations I do, it's more about being quicker. And I think that competitiveness gets people excited about math. So, yeah, I mean, that's my mission to actually make this much wider sport than what it is. Successfully, around 15, 20,000 people have been taking up this up on a weekly basis now. But
wow.
Aage jana hai.
Wow. I have one question. Let's do a test between Sagar Shah and Neelkanth Bhanu Prakash right now and see who is faster. Okay, ready Sagar bhai. Okay, ready Neelkanth.
Okay.
Sagar bhai. Neelkanth.
Yes.
Square root of 100.
10.
Both wrong, plus minus 10. Bye-bye, see you guys. See you guys later. Nobody mentioned minus 10. What has he done wrong? Okay.
Yeah. Minus 10
just.
I was expecting this, you know. I was like 10 बोलते हैं. I was like, अच्छा हाँ, minus आने वाला है. देखो अभी minus आने ही वाला है.
मैं बोला at least 10 में तो मैं उससे पहले बोल देता हूँ. बाद में गलत आंसर रहेगा.
I was thinking since morning what I can do to crack a joke out of this. Like first I thought 4, but then I knew 4 is too small, so one of you will be like plus minus 2. So yes, half successful.
Half successful.
Amazing. Biswa, and now time to put you in the spot.
Are why? I don't have any records.
No. Basically, so what the idea of this stream is that earlier Biswa was not streaming maths when I spoke with Bhanu, and at that point it was like he will teach me maths, how to improve at it, and I will teach him a bit of chess to improve at chess. And that was the entire
awesome.
Thing. And then you started streaming about maths. And so it was so great that this could be the perfect occasion to do this. So we start off with a game.
One second. I have more questions. Can I ask those questions? Not maths questions.
Absolutely. Jo bhi hai.
Yeah. I want to ask some serious questions. Do you think, were you able to do this as a child? Or did you like work on it to get better? Or like, is it inborn or can it be acquired?
There is no chance that this is inborn. मैं तो कुछ है ही नहीं ऐसे कुछ. I mean, बहुत लोग बोलते हैं जो ये फील्ड में होते हैं ना, they make themselves savants, but I don't think so. It's majorly working towards math, learning bunch of ways to optimize your methods, understanding human limitations, and then working around it. So बहुत practice ही है. I think people can do this.
Got it.
What will people be able to do, Neelkanth, after this stream or let's say a set of streams that we do? Yeah.
I think. For one, a starter would be to multiply, let's say, a number like 8,933 into 7, and you say the answer in a stretch.
Really?
So, I mean, as someone speaks, you can tell the answer. So, that's one. And that's not going to be any trick or anything. It's just a couple of thought processes which we understand which restrict our own nature of calculation. So, I think that could be one. But, yeah, bahut sare hai. I mean, aise kuch nahi hai ki math is relatively easy. It's easier to teach someone to get better at math than to make them better at chess. And I've realized that as you asked me to play chess a few times.
Oh, really?
So what is your opinion, maths or chess? Because you have done both. क्या ज्यादा टफ
यो सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई हैवन डन मैथ्स, आई हैव ओनली स्टडीड मैथ्स टू अ वेरी नॉर्मल लेवल. आई डोंट आई आई कांट डू द स्पीड मैथ्स एंड आई कांट डू स्लो मैथ्स आल्सो. ओके सो आई कैन ओनली टीच लाइक सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स दैट आई हैव लर्नड लाइक दैट. बट दिस इज अ वेरी स्पेसिफिक स्किल. सो द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज डज दिस like you said you can multiply 8933 into 7 fast, does this skill spill over into some other area of your life and help a lot?
Absolutely. Yeah. So one thing is that the way we do this calculation is about optimizing brain processes. So abhi if I have to put it this way, every processor or every computer ka complexity, time complexity is there, space complexity is there. So that's the limitation with the brain as well. So it's about understanding how do you manage both of them. For instance, I can talk to you and do the table of 43 in my mind. I'm going 86, 129, 172. I'm continuing to talk to you. I'm at 387, 430, 473, 516. Now, this is a very good example of multitasking. So it flows into how you can partition your thought. It flows into how you can manage distractions and a bunch of other things which can help otherwise. So, I mean, it's not restricted to math alone. In fact, if it was restricted to math alone, I would have left it a long time.
Got it. I was trying to do the table of two while you're talking. I couldn't do it. So I guess not everybody can become this guy. Sorry, guys in the chat who are hopeful, please leave right now. You cannot become. Sorry, I'm just joking.
It's not that difficult because of the sole reason that, I mean, we in general, human beings are, they're wired to be multitaskers. So,
and I have been reading books and they keep on telling me that whenever we multitask, it becomes difficult for us to do both. So it's better to just focus on one task at a time.
How often have books been right, Sagar? So, I mean, I don't know. I mean, theek hai. Ek baat ye hai ki it's a truth that you can't process two things at the same time. But it's like the fan, right? When it rotates so quickly, it's there everywhere. So the quantum position. So yeah, I mean, it's like being there both. You just have to go back and forth very quick. Yeah.
Cool.
Got
I'm
it.
Very excited to learn.
It's so, very...
What's your third question?
First of all, Sagar bhai, when you have to disagree with somebody, why do you take your glasses up like this and then speak? That's what I was thinking.
Really?
yeah. Like anytime you have to be like, ye Sagar bhai jab disagree karne wala na. But Biswa, ye position mein agar aapne ye chala, to aapko kaise laga ki? So okay, so next question is, most people are very comfortable doing calculations under 100, right? Like not multiplying two digit numbers with two digit numbers, but if a 17 into 7 bologe to koi kehna nikal ke kuch to bol denge jaldi jaldi, right? And I think that's majorly because logon ko 25 tak ke tables aate hain, nothing beyond that. But my question is, why innately we are just very bad at perceiving large numbers, and how do you overcome? Like for me, if you say 80,000 versus 90,000 versus 1 lakh versus 1,10,000, I don't like, if you say 8, 9, 10, 11, I form different images in my head, but 80,000, 90,000, 1 lakh, 1.1, I don't form any different images. It's just very large numbers.
Yes.
So do you have to train your brain to perceive this in a different way, or how does it work?
So, okay, there are two ways in which I can answer this question. Ek hai ki humans cannot perceive big numbers. That's because of the constraint ki we don't really associate 80,000 with anything in life, tangibly, right? So that is gone. But comparing 8, 9, 10 and 11 and saying ki 1.1 lakh is better, is bigger, is human way of optimizing. Well, that's natural way of coming back to limiting the amount of work you need to do. One thing which humans are extremely bad at doing, if not trained properly, is to maintain multiple bits of information, which is at the same time. Which in, for instance, I'm good with 80,000, I'm good with 17 also, but 80,000, 17 is very hard because it's 8 followed by two zeros and a zero again and 17. So, I think the process and human and that's working memory. So I mean, a cognitive process where just Sagar ji ko bhi baat, I was telling him the other day, which is that cognitive process mein, it's like our iterative memory, jo RAM hoti hai. So it's about how big your RAM is, how much can you hold, process and throw out. So that has to be increased. And none of what we do in school helps us because school mein bolte hain ki haram hai hi nahi to carry karenge dekho carry karenge from the end so we'll carry so we never go beyond two digits which is why we are fundamentally wired to have less cache memory
got it. That's where like that is one of the things that I little bit talk about in my streams also is that if you want a very accurate answer whatever was taught in school is useless because you can always use a calculator
absolutely right? No doubt about
yeah.
it
so I think schools mein they should teach the fundamentals much stronger so that people can you know take those things and apply in their lives rather than kisko carry karke idhar ek do jod rahe hain baith ke bachche log
I personally think mere paas char world record hai main bolta hu calculate karna is not a skill if you're using the school methods if it's not helping you if it's not helping you train your brain in anything else it's an absolute waste because wo calculator mein bhi kar sakte ho and people do abacus itna kharcha karke they do abacus I'm like usse better tool hai haath pe dekho na calculate kar do why learn a tool instead so whatever is in school the problem or whatever I've seen so far and I work towards it is that ye numbers ko bahut dump karne ke one reason is when you see 7343 into 8 tum ek ek ko karte jaoge but you never perceive that 7318 is 7318 wo batate hi nahi hai jo 7318 hai kuch kar do iske sath
got it
yeah
very interesting this is what I realized because a friend of mine wanted to do quick calculation and I didn't know any methods but what we did was so something like 35 into 53 if you have to do by the school method the first digit you get is 3 into 3 equals 9 which is the most insignificant digit
exactly
because you don't have the rest of the number yeah
it's like tum kuch dekh rahe ho par I mean you're getting the most insignificant as you mentioned right you're not even
yeah.
approximating it to the nearest something
correct but if you go just from the first digit 3 into 5 at least you know it's bigger than 1500 right away
absolutely.
But if you have 9 then what do you do with that 9 nothing right
absolutely
so yeah school method is very useless
I think that's another thing because
school wale bacche bhi dekh
hey bacche school mein jo sikhate hain wo bahut acha hai tum school ka padho hum log aise stream pe kuch bhi bolte hain yaar hamara kyun sunte
and one more thing is that we try to tend doing calculations from the end to the beginning while
yeah.
we read from the beginning to the end which is
Correct.
The problem it's like pura reverse karke perceive karo to kya hoga kuch nahi hoga so
yeah.
in fact wherever I go I encourage people to say ki acha tum left se right hi calculate karo jo bhi kar
very interesting
yes
those are all my questions nice
amazing we have a super chat by Tarun Chaudhary who says multitasking is often misunderstood as doing multiple things at a time it's doing one thing at a time but covering a lot of things in a certain period for example doing multiple things in a day
yeah. I mean ha time interval ka to kuch bhi slice kar sakte ho bilkul
right yeah. cool so very interesting and Bhanu I'm very keen on learning a few things from you today but before that we also have to make sure that you become a better chess player as well and
I've been doing horribly bad whenever I tried whenever I'm like theek hai do teen khelenge
what's your online rating like
1100
okay very cool so Biswa is now around 1450 1500 so he's stronger than you but usually Biswa is under pressure when he has such a match to play so it'll be interesting to see how it goes today and you both play the game today I'll commentate on it you can disconnect from the sound when you begin playing
okay
it can be a 10 minute game what's your ID on the Chessbase account that you made
yeah it's Neelkanth Bhado I'm just gonna send it to you
okay maybe Biswa if you can find him in the
I have found him I have sent him a request 10 minutes
yeah
okay 10 minutes rated should I add some increment 10 minutes 10 seconds I'm adding
okay
I have sent you a request Neil what do I call you Neil or Counter
Bhanu is fine
Bhanu is fine no?
Yeah it's the South Indian thing so yeah
no my name is Biswa Kalyan Rath so people get even more confused
I accepted.
Oh, I am playing as guest. ओके फाइन, शुड आई कंटिन्यू एज गेस्ट सागर भाई?
हाँ चलेगा।
ओके आई एम रिमूविंग माय हेडफोन्स।
ओके इवन आई एम रिमूविंग माय हेडफोन्स।
ओके गाइस लेट मी फर्स्ट सी वेयर दे आर एंड देयर गेम। ओके हियर इज द गेम, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग। नीलकंठ इज प्लेइंग विद द वाइट पीसेस एंड ही इज ओ ही प्लेड नाइट टू एफ थ्री। बिस्वा हु इज द गेस्ट हैज प्लेड नाइट सी सिक्स। And guys, today's idea of playing this game is to assess the strength of Bhanu, how good he is. He plays his bishop out to b5, threatening to take on c6 here in this position. So already he's playing pretty well. And Biswa, of course, the higher rated player of the two, will be under some pressure. And Biswa plays bishop d6. Guys, this is supposed to be a decent move. Yeah, like the idea is when he takes on c6 like this, you take back with the d pawn so that this bishop opens up and this is well placed. But very cool move by Bhanu also. He castled, so clearly he's playing very well. d3 yeah, he has 4 world records, so what do you expect? You know, he'll be good at everything he does. h6. Okay, oh, and knight to d5, and he's moving quickly, not even thinking much. Is my sound low? Okay. Now is it better, guys? So the idea could be Biswa can take this guy, pawn takes, and knight e7. This could be a possibility. Oh, I'm very glad that on play chess now I can make arrows. Very cool. Pawn takes, now knight e7. If Bhanu wins today, that will be crazy. Crazy, but okay. I feel that Biswa, rook e1 is such a cool move. He's attacking the e5 pawn and also here. And Biswa very quickly, nice move here. Knight to g6. Ooh, h4. I think this is, first of all, you can take this pawn, but when you take it, he can take here. So is this really an idea that he thought of so quickly? I don't believe it. And now, of course, bishop is attacked. So I think bishop c4 makes a lot of sense. Bishop a4, the bishop is doing nothing on this diagonal. So there's no point of keeping that bishop here. So I would rather play the bishop to c4. Aha, yes, Ilian, I will ask him about his accent. Ooh, h5. Wow, this I did not consider. What a move. What a move. So the point is, if you take here, he wants to take here. Let me just see how Biswa is reacting. Oh, Biswa under pressure there. Bhanu very confident. I like how he's thinking. Such moves can really put the opponent under pressure. H5, because generally when you attack something, you think it will move. I really did not consider this move, guys. Oh, knight h4. Arshab says, I analyzed our game. It's a shame to see me missing some important moves. Thanks for the game. I'm definitely much better than the last year. Arshab, I also felt you were very good. In fact, I think we played in improving chess before. And you have improved a lot. Oh, this is a nice move. You can't take on e5 because ab5 is hanging. So Biswa gets to exchange the knights. Now let's see if Bhanu doesn't get confused here, because he doesn't have too much practice of playing. So if he takes here on e5, g3, this is a blunder because now after knight f3, queen f3, ab5, that would lose a piece. So it's very important, it was necessary here to save this bishop. g3 does not work. Queen f3, and now just take. Yeah, there was a small nod of his head and he realized that he had made a mistake. Also, guys, after this game, we will analyze it. Maybe if they are keen, we will play another game because I think Biswa already piece up, shouldn't have too many difficulties here. We'll also maybe play another game. And then we will learn a few maths tricks from Bhanu because I really want to improve at maths. And who knows, it could be useful in general to for my faster brain calculations, or I know that you have different skill sets for calculating on chessboard and also on maths, related to maths, but still, in a way, you're using your same brain, so it could be nice to learn something new. And this was the entire idea, so that you guys can get to learn something different as well. Queen e2 has been played by Bhanu. Now, Biswa has gone off the chair. This is in, violation of our anti-cheating measures. Maybe Biswa gets a loss here, but okay, we will make an exception from the anti-cheating. Vanshdhar said, how to become fluent in chess language, like you say, a5, d4. I have streams on Chessbase India where you learn notations, but in general, if you just ask someone to click on a square like this, which is this square, f2, f4, c4, and you keep doing it for a week, e6, g6, h7, e8, a3, b3, b1, f1, you will get better at it. Now I need to get rid of all these squares. But that's how you learn notations. There's no magic rule, and in fact, I always remember Ramesh, RB Ramesh's words when I asked him how should one learn notation. He said very simply, if someone wants to learn it, he will learn it. There is nothing like, it's just a matter of some will that you want to learn it. Also, Biswa has usually, when he's a piece up, he tends to go wrong. Sometimes he gets a little bit defensive, but today he's playing pretty well. He's pushed the queen away. Now maybe just come back with the queen. What else to do? So there's no other square, good square. Maybe you can go to g2 or h1. Yeah. Yes, Arshab, there's very good exercise on Lee Chess for notations. True. If you go to Lee Chess, there is a notation tab there, I think in Learn or something, where you can, the moment a screen lights up, a square lights up, you can click on, you can, I think you have to type which square it is, and you can learn that way. It's a good one. Queen to f3 has been played. And now, what does Biswa do next? If he takes here, then there is queen d5 check and the bishop hangs. So that's not a good idea. Maybe just queen f6. Biswa taking his time here, and he has queen f6. Cool move. What a good move. I think, I mean, it's such a position where you have absolutely no play. Could go bishop d2, bishop c3. Yeah, Biswa's bishop is stuck here. So if you take here, he will take back with the pawn and open it up. But overall, I think even if you don't take it, sooner or later, Biswa will activate it via b6, bb7. So this looks very, very difficult now for Bhanu to save this. Meanwhile, guys, if you want to follow Neelkanth, this genius, on you can do so from the title on his channel. I have linked his channel in the title. You can follow him there. Okay, c3. No, just a solid move. It's a good move. Just putting a pawn here. b6, nice move. And now you can just put your bishop here. Maybe Bhanu can win a pawn here with d takes c6 and queen takes c6. But I mean, it opens up this bishop. Plays bishop to e3. And now bishop b7 by Biswa. Remember, cd5 would be a huge blunder because queen d5 check and you lose the rook. Of course, Biswa is not going to make such a blunder here. Dushyant, how to improve calculations? My calculations are so weak. Dushyant, try to follow slow and steady with Biswa. We work a lot on calculations there. I feel that sometimes there are things which are already available there. Most of the things in order to improve are available, just that you have to put in some effort. You have to search it. You have to look for it. Yes, Garvit, you are very right. He says, I played a blindfold game against my sister who was 950 rated. Although it was difficult to see the entire board, it helped me to understand the chessboard better. And that is always true. Whenever you play a blindfold game, it improves your chess understanding a lot. So if you get a chance to play blindfolded, try it. Maybe you can do 2 moves, 3 moves at a time. And then slowly the chessboard will start building. I remember I used to go to a chess club. And one of the boys came and told me, let's play a blindfold game. And I said, okay. He played e4. I could play 1 or 2 moves and suddenly I couldn't even see the board after it. And I said, but I don't see it. Eventually I could, you know. So it's all about practice. You have to try. You don't have to give up. Bishop b6. Nice pawn captured. Both the players taking a lot of time. What I did not like is that in the opening, when it was important to take some time, at that point they did not take time, especially Bhanu. He played a little too quickly. Again, b4 is a move which is played a bit too quickly. I think Biswa can either take this bishop b4, cb4, and then snap off this bishop. You see, there's a discovered attack here. Or I think Biswa will go e4. That's also a nice move. Aditya Verma, yes, there is a Play Chess Android app which is free totally. So you can download Play Chess. You go to Google Store and download Play Chess where you can play online. But there is no evaluation bar here. So that I cannot bring. But maybe in future, just like how till today, I think the arrows weren't there. It's there now. Maybe the evaluation bar will also come. Tanuj Jain, books for beginners who just know the basics, I would definitely recommend the chess course. It's a great, great book by Praful Zaveri. You can also type chess course on our YouTube channel and you will find an interview with him. And you will get to know what the book is about. And then eventually you can decide whether you want to. It's a fantastic book. DE. Sometimes I do feel that after I've spent so much time with Biswa on streams teaching him, I can guess his moves. What he will play. Okay, let's see if I can guess his next move. Right now, I think Bhanu will play Queen E2, although I still don't know him so well to guess his move. But Queen E2 looks like a decent move there. Yeah, I mean, black has a beautiful bishop here, dangling down the board. Another bishop looking. Oops, not there, not there, not there. This way, this way. Another bishop looking here. Oh, nice, queen e2. Okay, now let me guess Biswa's move. Okay, Biswa will think to himself, f4, I want to attack. But my b5 pawn is hanging. He would not like to calculate. So he will go bishop c6 and he will save everything. But he will also think in his head, bishop takes g3, fg3, queen b6, check. Ah, that also looks interesting because it's a tactic. But I still feel he will try to save himself. You know, that is his kind of the way he thinks. So bishop c6 is my guess for Biswa's move. Queen c3 is also possible, but oh, he played bishop g3. Wow, Biswa, well done, well done. Well done, this was a good move. And now if FG3, you can take this bishop. There is also bishop D4, by the way, if Bhanu can find this move, but Biswa can just drop back his bishop to E5. So it's not really hanging. Oh, green arrow also works. Nice, nice. So if I do Alt and this, there's a green arrow. Oh, yellow arrow for control alt. Awesome. Shift alt, red. Nice. Bishop d4, Bhanu plays it. Now I think Biswa has to find bishop e5, which he will. Yes. Oh, queen e6. Why? Why Biswa now? Bishop fg3. The game is not over now anymore. No? fg3, take it. I think Biswa just missed it. Let me see his. Bhanu looks very, very comfortable now. Guys, materially, now Biswa is only a pawn up. Oh my God. Of course, the king is very exposed on g1. f4 is coming in to open up the rook, the queen. But I think Biswa would have been slightly flustered here. And Bhanu's confidence is very high. You can see he looks very confident.
यार आई डोंट नो व्हाट आई डिड मिसक्लिक हो गया यार आई वाज जस्ट होल्डिंग द क्वीन एंड नाउ आई सी द पोजीशन इज गॉन ओके आई एम म्यूटिंग अगेन आई हैव टू प्ले फ्रॉम
Oh, nice. This is a nice thing, no? When you can actually, like, imagine in a game. You can hear the player's thought process. So you are here, I'm commentating. Oh, Biswa missed this and all of it. And suddenly Biswa comes and says, Are queen misclick ho gaya and all of this. So you get to know. Very cool, very cool. Yes. Arvind Swaminathan, yes, there was a confession booth, correct, over the board game. Now Biswa has to maintain his cool. See, the thing is, when you talk about mental calculation and what Bhanu is going to teach us eventually, maths and all, there's something known as mental toughness. And because chess is a sport where you have an opponent, toughness needs to be shown here. Now Biswa knows that he was a piece up. Suddenly he loses a piece. If he looked at this position with a fresh eye, he would be like, I'm still winning. I'm pawn up. If I count the pawns, I'm one extra pawn. And f4, look at this king, horribly weak. My rook gets activated. This bishop could become strong. And then the queen comes here. Wow, Biswa has played it. Very nice. He shows mental strength. He shows his mental strength here. And now Bhanu has a very difficult choice here to make. If he takes g takes f4, rook swoops in. And then the king is very open with check here, the other rook coming in. It looks very dangerous. But if he pushes his pawn forward, then these two are monsters here on f4 and e4. So both these pawns become impossible to hold. Oh, he plays g4. And now remember, guys, the right way always is to push your pawn to e3 so that it's on the opposite color of your bishops. Okay? But Biswa pushes f3. Now, this is a mistake. It's not a mistake, by the way, guys. Because tactically, these two pawns positionally are now halted because of the bishop. But tactically, the queen moves, g4 is hanging. So, this doesn't work. And I think Bhanu has to be careful. If he moves his queen lightly somewhere, let's say he moves his queen to e3 or something, then queen g4. And it's a mate on g2. So, I guess he will have to play queen f2. Queen f2, queen g4. King f1. Queen h5. I mean, you just lost two pawns there. And with three pawns down, it's not going to help you. Guys, please like the stream. Maths plus chess match. Yeah, I know everyone at the start was calling it mess and all. But I'm very excited. Oh, nice move by Bhanu. Because it was the only move, in a way, to prevent f2 check, losing a rook, and also g2 mate. So this was a good move. Relatively good in a bad position. Now king f1. Because if you go king h1... then queen h5 also comes with a check. Or better, even better, if king h1, then I could go rook f5 with the idea of rook h5. And you know, this is like this lawnmower mate if the king goes there. Oh, Biswa is playing awesome. He's given a check here. Now king has to go to g1. Only move. And then just rook f5. Rook f5, rook g5. You could go rook f4. Nice. Nice. This is all over. And Biswa showing his class here. And playing. In his moves are like, I would say, a strong chess player. He at least finds these moves. He knows these patterns. Check, check, then bring the rook in. Already he's like a half professional player. Yes, Hardik Gupta, you are right. Bhanu played very well. I expected him to play weaker than this. So he has played well. Of course, all praise goes to Biswa here because he's winning the game. But just imagine that Bhanu plays hardly any chess and he's still able to fight pretty well. What to do now? How to stop this? There's just no way. Maybe queen h2, but then f2. No, queen hill jata hai, to pawn aage aa jata hai. And then if you don't move the queen, what do you do? Yeah, he found. And the thing is, if you give a check here, there is King H1 and still some fight, no? Oh, by the way, F2, Bishop F2, Queen H2, King H2, Rook F2. I mean, to find this defensive move, Queen H2 is commendable. Well done, Bhanu. Well done. Okay, I'm just thinking now. Rook G4, King H1, F2. Okay, F2 doesn't work. Queen is hanging. So, how about, guys? Look at this. This is a very cool variation. F2. Let's see if Biswa finds it. F2 check. Let me first remove all the arrows to make it very clean. Okay, F2 check. Bishop F2 forced. Otherwise, you lose a rook. Rook G4 check. Again, King H1 forced. There is no other move. E3 check. And look at this bishop unleashing on the long diagonal. That would be amazing if Biswa finds it. No, he first gives a check. Now, if first check, maybe not the best. Not the best. King H1. It's the only move, Bhanu. You can't play anything else. Oh, look at this. Biswa offers a draw. Why did Biswa offer a draw? I don't know why Biswa offered a draw there. And Bhanu, I think, didn't even see that there is a draw offer. He's like, maybe now he did this. Oh, draw offer was there. I could have taken it. I didn't see it. But anyway, I think Biswa's draw offer came more from the fact that he didn't want to beat him. But the game is not over yet, guys. Look at this. Look at Biswa's face. He's like, "अरे मेट नहीं हो रहा है." How about sacrificing the queen? Does that work? Like F2, Queen H3, E3 check, King H2. I doubt. So he takes. Now queen takes. Okay. Of course it is winning. Of course Biswa is winning. But the game. Rook G2 check. Now let's go king. Maybe King H3 was better slightly because now you are in this attack, but Rook F8. Okay. Rook G1. Cool. And Bhanu taking care of his time. You know, he's coming low on time and he realizes it. Takes. Rook takes. Is Biswa going to find this difficult to win? Because he has to do this E3, Bishop E3, F2 idea, sacrificing his pawn and opening up his bishop. He can also play F2 directly. Guys, one second. What is he going to do? What is he going to do, Biswa? Rook. Oh no, Rook F7. He had to play that because there was a threat here. And look at Bhanu very quickly moving his bishop back and blocking this pawn, which is very. I think this guy, if I teach him seriously for a few days. Yes, F2 Rook G7. Correct, Omkar. Sorry, I just missed it. But if he learns chess, he'll really improve quickly because this bishop E3 and all these moves, very cool. Shows great control on nerves. For someone who's playing chess, maybe for the first time on stream against Biswa, who's been playing regularly. This is great. Fantastic. Okay, nice move by Biswa, by the way. Rook H5. Now hitting here. Okay, maybe Rook G3. If you play Rook H5, I can go King G1. But if I go Rook G3, there is F2, F1. Yeah, I don't see how you can save this King H2. Okay, take. Maybe activating the king. Because there is opposite color bishops, no? There is still some hope. Some. Very slight hope. Very slight hope. And to save that position from an attack was very cool. What Bhanu did. Very impressive. Because now there's no Rook G5 check. The bishop will simply take it. So if there's no Rook G5 check, how does Biswa proceed? Also, he should remain careful because if king f4, he plays d5, puts another pawn on dark square, on light square. Not so sure about his technique here. King f4 and bishop d4 seems like a good plan. Yes, good move, Bhanu, good move. Rook h2. Oh, now can we go bishop d4? But there's g5. And then I want to go in further. Yeah, these pawns are quite strong. Bishop d4 he plays. I think Biswa will go g5. That's his only move. What else? What else to do? Oh, rook g2. Nice. Rook g2 is there. Was there. Exchanging the rooks, take, f takes, and then king g3 and picking up this pawn would mean that you are then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 versus 3. Could there be some drawing chances there? I don't think so, because these two additional pawns... But still, I think that might be the best chance here, because if you move your rook away somewhere, okay, maybe rook a1... Then there is f2. Okay, rook f2, rook f1. Yeah, it's... Yeah, he took. Okay, king g3. Opposite color bishops are always tricky, guys, because black's bishop controls only light squares. You see in this position, white bishop controls dark squares. So, in a way... Oh, no, my God. Look at Biswa. He's pushing his pawns carelessly. Now, they could be blockaded on the light square... On the... Just king h4, dark squares, he cannot... You should not push your pawns on light squares when you have a light squared bishop. This could end in a draw, guys. This could end in a draw. Now, but for Bhanu, it's very difficult. Oh, he takes the pawn. He gets one pawn back, g3. King back. Oh my God, this could be a draw. King h3, can't believe it. What does Biswa do now? King e5, take the pawn. It's a draw, guys. Wow. Oh my God. Too good. King f2. Just block this. Yes. He's found it. Bishop g4. Bishop e3, check. Yeah, go back, check. Guys, this Bhanu is very strong to hold this endgame. Bishop d1. Guys, if this ends in a draw, should we have a small blitz game? 5 plus 2 or something? Because what a game that was. Okay, is Biswa going to somehow trick Bhanu, or I don't think so. No, now it's too difficult to trick from this position. Draw?
Yeah, how well played, brother.
Oh man, what a game.
He played so well.
That was nice.
That was unbelievable game. I felt like at some point, Biswa played amazingly well. Bhanu, then you fought back like crazy. I mean, what a game.
I gave the first piece away. I was like, what? Oh, wow. How did that happen?
I had a major misclick in the middle where, I was just holding the queen and then I don't know how my move happened. And then I was supposed to take a bishop or something. Then I didn't take it. Then that's where the pieces became equal again.
But Biswa... that was nice when you came on stream and said that I moved the queen. So we understood that was a misclick. But after that also, you were almost going to checkmate him.
Yeah, then I don't know. Something I missed. I missed something. Let's see this analyzed. It's very interesting. Let's
analyze this game.
I think one thing which I was like actually stuck on a lot was like the king h1. I was not sure if I should go there or not for a long time. But then I was like, okay, maybe. Let's just give it a try.
No, I think you made Biswa, work hard for that point, which was very difficult. I mean, I thought you will just crumble under pressure.
No, no, he's very competitive, dude. He's not giving anything. No mistakes after the first mistake. He was like, your calculation is really very amazing. Like, you could see every threat coming and you stopped everything.
Yes.
It's damn nice. But I created so many threats and he saw all of them. Then I'm like, okay, fine, now what to do?
Okay, I will just get the chessboard so we can just go over the game very quickly and try to understand some key elements where both of you could have improved. Although everyone is saying tiebreaker,
Wow.
but we will do that later. Okay. So e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6, knight c3, knight f6, bishop b5, and bishop d6. Nice move, actually. It's theory. Did you know this?
No.
Yeah, it's a nice move because at some point, if Bhanu does take on c6, it blocks the d pawn. You know, the bishop cannot come out anymore. But if he does take here, then take, and then your bishop comes out. So
Yeah.
this was pretty fine. And then it was castles.
Great game.
Castles. d3. h6 was played here. And Bhanu, how do you play all these opening moves? Do you know some theory or something?
No. I just know, I think a couple of them, get your knights out and then play. That's
Yeah, so it's very good what you have done until now. You got both your knights out in the center. You control the center with your pawns. You have your
all. Correct.
bishop outside the pawn chain, and now next your this bishop is ready to move. So you
Yeah.
did everything.
The only the bishop b5 usually is I play anticipating an a6 because I can go back and maybe if someone's aggressive b5 so that their pawns are open. That's usually the idea.
Yeah, this is what you played is completely fine. By the way, Joy Datta says this was an amazing game. Bhanu played exceptional.
Thank you.
It's too good. Really too good.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
So
Man, you should
take.
try for some chess world records also.
Wow, that's a long way to. That's an entirely different field, not my forte.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But no, I think you can improve very quickly, that's for sure. So take.
Because your calculation as such is very strong. For
Thank you.
1100 rating, yeah, it's very strong.
Rook e1. Okay, now he attacked here and Biswa, good move. Knight g6. And I actually, here I was thinking, what will Bhanu do and all of that. And suddenly h4. This came as a surprise to me. I was like, why did you play h4, Bhanu?
Was thinking of h5 later.
It's and then next moment a6. I was like, okay, bishop c4 seems normal now to save. And I think, Bhanu, this might be a better move. But you pushed h5.
I don't know. I think somehow, okay, I think this is a bias, but I think I can handle my knights well. So
But usually, you know, bishops are slightly stronger than knights. Although they
Mm-hmm.
both are 3 points, but in open positions, bishops do better. Here it works out tactically also because if Biswa takes your bishop, you take the knight. And then if pawn takes and you have won a pawn, if you count the pawns, white has 7, black has
Yes.
8, but
Yes.
then you go and take this guy.
Yeah, that's also something which I was looking at, and also a double pawn in front of the queen.
Yes, but I still prefer black's chances here because mainly because queen, rook, and bishop they all are well developed, and but it was still playable. I think Biswa's move was also good, knight h4 here, and here is where you made the big error. G3.
Yeah.
Can you find a better move than g3?
At this point,
Yes.
I could take the that would come again, but sure, not really that big a threat.
See, when you take his piece, then queen comes into the game, which is not to your benefit. So why should you take it? What would be better?
I played g3. I could play king f1.
No, but your bishop is hanging on b5 here.
Not sure. What would I actually
You
do?
need to save it.
Saving was good.
So here, and this would be much better. And then if Biswa takes here, then you take, and I think white is doing very well. I mean, no problems. So here, of course, g3, and I thought now the game is over because Biswa won a piece. But you had
The
some
game
other
has just
moves.
begun.
but you had some other plans. Here, queen e2 was played, c6, queen e4, f5. So, good play by Biswa till here. Queen f3, queen f6, also good move. You went c3. And now I think, Biswa, you went b6. Makes a lot of sense. You wanted to put your bishop here.
So, I mean, for me, the logical explanation for c3 was I wanted to go b4 for a lot of time, but I could not do it.
But why you want to go b4?
No, I don't know. I mean, I don't know.
I mean, what I would suggest here is to go maybe bishop d2. And put the bishop here to put pressure. So generally, you know how chess works is you find spots in opponent's position which are weak and try to build up on it. So if e5 is weak here, you try to attack here. There is a small echo, no? I don't know. From either your end or Biswa's end, I don't... Hello? Ah, now there is no echo.
So it's from my end.
Biswa, when you opened that food and packet and all, itna awaz aise aaya na, sab log were like, "Arey, kya kha?"
I thought I was muted the whole time.
No, it was like I said, pura the bag ka awaz. Okay, just going through now. C3, B6, Bishop E3, good move. Here, Bishop B7. You took this pawn, CD. Again, all good chess by Biswa. Until now, Biswa has played a great game, I would say. and then, after CD5, the move that was played in this position was B4, E4. Yeah, this is where all the fireworks began. So, you played B4, he went E4, good move, and then DE, and here you went Queen E2, and I was like, Biswa won't take on G3 now, because you know, this is hanging, he will think my B5 pawn is hanging, so he will go and save it, and Biswa actually took it, so there's great improvement there, Biswa taking on G3, calculating it, and what is the best move for black now, Biswa? You're muted.
Just bishop f2.
No. Why give up that piece?
Okay, then queen h4.
No, then also fg3 loses a piece.
Okay, you want me to play bishop e5.
Exactly, because you are piece up, you come back and you stay piece up.
I was also expecting that to come.
Yeah, but then I couldn't think this move because I was holding my queen and thinking, and then I just dropped the queen and I didn't realize I was still thinking until your next move came. Thankfully, I didn't blunder the queen with a mistake.
Yeah. I mean, at least you didn't drop the queen somewhere. But queen e6, Biswa was okay because after this, you came on air and you said like, you know, I blundered a piece and all. And I thought now mentally you would crumble. But next move was very good, f4. Because it opens up this rook, opens up the queen, also opens up the bishop now. So Bhanu had a very difficult decision to make. To take here would mean that the rook comes in. And this is very dangerous attack with the other rook also swinging. So there, you pushed here. And now, here is one very important rule, Biswa, in which you should, this game...
I was expecting f3.
He played f3.
No, so I was expecting e3, sorry.
Why e3? Can you tell why e3 is better than f3?
Bishop comes to attack.
Bishop opens up, right?
Exactly. When you have a light squared bishop, you put your pawns on dark squares so that the bishop can be activated. But Biswa's move was not bad, f3, because it's very concrete and it attacks the g4 pawn. And here, Bhanu, if you would have played any other move, then queen
g4. It is done.
That's what I realized. I was actually looking at everything. I think I was also losing out on time there.
Yeah. So you found actually, I think, a very, very logical defensive move, queen f2. Then Biswa took here. King h1 means it's gone because king h1, Biswa, how do you finish this off?
It's... Queen h3 is mate, I think. Not mate. queen h3.
Bring all your pieces into the attack. When
I got it, then rook f4.
E3 is also an interesting move, but e3 he will take with the bishop, keeping this pawn blocked. But it is a good move. Rook f5 is just very strong. Next
one. Mate in one.
Yeah. This is known as like some kind of a rolling mate or a lawnmower's mate, where you just capture both the files of the king to there's no way to escape. So queen f2 takes. You went king f1. Now good move. Check. He went here. Excellent move, Biswa, coming in. I was like, abhi khatam. Game is over. Rook aa raha hai. But only defensive move. Well done, Bhanu. Here you found a very strong.
This was like a log. I was like, oh, finally. Okay, idhar to kuch ho sakta hai.
So now, both of you, here's your question. Black to play and finish off the game smoothly. You know, this is the thing which separates good players from best. They finish them off.
Is it?
Calculate a little bit ahead. Don't, let
what
it go.
What move did Biswa play?
Biswa played rook g4 check. He gave a check with the rook here, and then the king went to
is
h1.
Is it e3?
But check what is hanging for black.
Black, it's the queen.
Queen is hanging, so if you play e3, then queen takes queen, and maybe it doesn't work.
F2.
Go on.
But f2, bishop takes f2.
Then?
F2,
so you see
f2,
you have to take it, because
yeah,
if you don't take it,
let's
then
check.
Your rook goes if you move the king. So therefore bishop f2 is forced. Then now finish the calculation.
Queen takes queen, I guess.
Oh, it's like again selling yourself a little too cheaply. You will win a piece, Biswa, but mate kar do.
What is the mate here? I couldn't find this mate also.
You see, when you give this check with your rook, the problem
he goes to
is
H1.
King H1, but now when you have played F2, did you see it?
So you, wow, you play E3.
When?
Now.
Okay, E3. I take your queen.
Not now. Like after F2.
Okay,
F2
takes
E3.
No, but then queen H3.
But now.
Actually, no, nothing happens. So.
Not yet, because here takes and it's still not clear. I mean, how you will win.
Wow.
So,
okay.
Don't give your queen. You're close.
Okay, now rook g4 check.
Yes.
Oh man. Now e3.
And
whenever
the king
goes, there
goes here, now e3.
Fantastic.
So that f2 check was important.
Yeah. I was calculating, but it didn't seem like there was anything there. So
no,
I just.
Here, Biswa, you can't go into an endgame. You have to finish such a king which is exposed. And now started Bhanu's. Sort of resurgence here. Check. King here. Takes. Rook g2. King came here. You played rook f8. Now very good move. Rook g1. Takes. And now suddenly, all of a sudden.
There's an attack there, no?
Yeah. Yes. This became like a very dangerous thing. So Biswa saved it. And I can't believe that Bhanu actually played the next move. Which was bishop e3.
That's the
why did you play this?
No, it's to get the check, right? I mean, I can take the h pawn.
I know you can take the h pawn, but the most important thing you did with this move was you blocked this entire two pawns.
Yeah, he can't even push that.
Exactly.
That was a straight check anyway.
Yeah. So
in fact, I was actually getting fidgety a lot. I was like, I like the e and f pawns. Let them stay.
Yeah, you went here. Biswa actually saved that pawn. King h7, and then a3 was not the best idea here that you played, but anyway, your position was not great. So rook f5, and again now this is a good idea because here your king is coming up.
Yes.
And
bishop, otherwise it was mate.
Oh, yes, exactly.
Otherwise it was mate.
So here, and now d5 is something Biswa you shouldn't do, because the more pawns you place on the same color as your bishop, the difficult it is for you to break through. So imagine ye pawn yahan nahi hota, so then at some point in the endgame, your king would have used this square to come in this way.
Yes.
But because you placed it, you kind of got stuck. So king f4, good move Bhanu here. Rook here, bishop d4, attacking this. I was expecting Biswa to go g5 check now, but Biswa said I will exchange the rooks. Which
then
is
I think
fine.
I thought for a lot of time here, I was like, kya hoga?
You have to, I mean otherwise, and now the most important part, Biswa, you already know this, is to keep your pawns on these two pawns. On which
dark
colors?
Squares.
Yes, exactly. You need to be need them to be on dark squares, and look what you did in your hurry, when you had time actually. It was not like you were low on time. Tumne khela g5. Here, sorry, one second. You played g5, he took this, you played h5, and you played g4, and this is where it all ended in a draw now. Because opposite color bishops, even though black is two pawns up, now it's difficult because he has no control on dark squares because of this bishop. So the right move here was to get the king here and push h4 so that you have control on light square with the bishop and the pawns control dark squares.
Got it.
And then you would have won.
Got it. Very interesting. I just thought I have two extra pawns. There's no role. And then they didn't.
Ha. So this is a good lesson in endgame,
yeah,
that keep your pawns on the opposite color of your bishop.
I'll just be back in a minute.
Sure. Bhanu, how did you enjoy this? I mean, it was beyond my expectations the way you played.
No, it was nice. I mean, I don't play as well. I mean, I usually am half asleep when I play. So usually I play towards the night. So this was nice.
Too good. And by the way, Biswa had offered you a draw in between, I think.
I actually saw that sometime later. I was looking at the notes.
Yes,
I saw you.
What?
I was like, what? I should have taken it. Because that time I didn't have a good position at all. I was like, should have as well.
No, but I think that was Biswa's way of saying that, okay, we are on a fun stream first time. I don't want to beat you. But then he played on and then eventually it ended in a draw.
Yeah. I'm thankful that I didn't see it.
Yeah.
I think I don't know the interface. Suddenly, I think some pop-up came, but I didn't know what happened. I was like, okay, I resume.
Upper offer draw would have lit up.
Acha. Don't know how this works.
This was nice.
Bhanu also offered me a take back in the middle. I don't think he was doing it intentionally.
I was just looking at it. I was like, "Okay, kya hai?" As I know, right? I don't know the interface, and I was like,
Okay.
"Yeah." But great game, man. Great game. Really had fun. Like you played. You didn't give a single inch. You fought till the end. Very nice.
Yeah. Great.
Fantastic. So Bhanu, we have now I know your strength a bit more. So the next streams, whenever we do match part 2, part 3, I know what I can show you. Can we learn a bit of maths now?
Absolutely. So basically, we're gonna use something, right? I mean, when you calculate in chess, I mean, from whatever I've read of little, it's about thinking ahead. And I think today I'll actually tell you about how to think ahead in a multiplication. That's pretty much it. It's about thinking ahead and actually pretending, or for that matter, it'll look to you like I'm doing calculations and I'm giving you the right answer, but I'm doing as I speak out. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Yeah. So I'll share my screen if that's okay.
Yes, please do share. I will set it up. So just share it.
I'll share my whiteboard first so that I'll probably, like, if you can, I don't know how that looks.
Yeah. Now I have this here. So let me.
And Biswa, Sagar, your blockchain wala stream was great. I actually was going through it the other day.
Oh, thanks, man.
I made a poll on my Instagram where I asked people, is Biswa a better teacher or a better student? And the answer was teacher.
Folk.
he teaches very well and he does his research very well, and tough topics he converts them into very easy digestible topics.
In fact, one thing which I was observing, that was the same very thing. This one I teach as well. Like I teach in a lot of places.
Awesome.
I'm actually starting out as an assistant prof, visiting professor at IIT Hyderabad, the youngest.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Oh, great.
It's in math and cognition. So I was actually thinking about the same thing, about how do you make it fun and as dumbed down as possible, use as many less symbols as possible and make people understand math. Yeah, interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. So is this good?
That's okay. That should be fine.
I will just take away the chess.
Yeah. Cool. So the objective, and Biswa and Raj Sagar, is to be able to do calculations like this. Something like this, very easily. Or let me put it in a much more, I think let's make it this way. It's about doing calculations like this very easily. Now, my first question would be, how would you go about something like this, Sagar?
I usually, if I am given such things, I will do 6,000 into 4, which is 24,000, and 350 into 4, which is 1,400, and 4 into 4, which is 16. So this is how I would get the answer.
From what Sagar told me, it's this. Biswa, how would you go about this?
Same, similar.
Similar, right?
Yeah.
Now, the logic here is, everyone here is going from the left corner to the right corner, and for people who are watching this or whatever, this is a better way to go about, because you can write the answer. I mean, there's an understand. Now, if I'm putting on, and I'm gonna tell you how, what being in being a, let's say, human calculator, what this means is this. I'm gonna just rub it down and write the standard procedure, which is this. I mean, you did a 350 into 4, which is great. But usually people do it this way, which is they break this also, and they break this as well, right? Mm-hmm. And they finally get the answer. Now, can you tell me, Sagar, which of these numbers are redundant? These ones.
Are redundant.
Redundant, they don't matter to the answer.
All the zeros?
Absolutely, these don't matter. Clearly, they don't, right? So ideally, if someone's supposed to do this calculation, holding or storing them is a mistake. I mean, it's a mistake, because if the same question was around, let's say, 7, 3, 8, 3, 2, 4, 5, 8 multiplied by 8, you can't do the same logic. You can't build it, because this will become, what do we say? 56,604,240,000, 16,000. 3,240, 64. There's no way you add all of them. Which means that I should find a way that I consume this information as I calculate. Does that make sense?
Mm.
I should consume the number as I calculate. So, since these don't make any sense, I'm just gonna draw this fun, let's say, circle here. This is your brain. This is what's happening in it, right? I'm just tackling the same question, which is 6, 3, 5, 4. Multiplied by 4. I would go about it in this way. I would just look at it 24 first. Yeah? 24. Now, the next thing I look at is 12, which is 3 into 4. I know that there is something here which is going to be a 0, but I don't care, because I don't really want it. So I ideally try to position it this way, which is 24 and 12. Now think of it this way, 24 and 12, 4 and 1 combined, what's that?
5.
Right? So I actually write down the answer, 2, 5. What's on my mind now?
2, 5, 2.
Right? I mean, it's 24.
2, 5, 2. Oh, got it.
24, 12. So if both of these get added, it's 25. And there's 2 left. Yeah. I have not done anything with the 2.
Mm.
Now it's 5 times 4. What is that?
20.
So 2 and 20. So this is a new type of addition which I'm trying to teach you, where when I say this plus, I'm literally asking you to add these two, only the adjacent numbers,
uh-huh.
Right? So I'm just going to use a new symbol for it. So 2, 20, what this would be, what would this be? 40, because it's 2 and 2 together. So it's 4. I have 0 on my mind, 0 and 16. That would give me 1, 6. Right? So the way I went about this is I started with 24, 252-2540-25416. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Okay.
Sagar, does this make sense a little?
So basically, 6 into 4, 24. And then you did 3 into 4, right? So it was 12. So you removed the tens place, you only kept the units, and one you transferred to 24.
The problem is, the moment you start thinking about tens and units, this gets messy.
Okay.
So I wanted to think of it this way. 24 hai, ye 12 ko dhakka maar diya, so the one got merged to this. That's it.
Theek hai.
Right?
तो उधर दो नंबर रहेगा तो एक को ये साइड धक्का मारने का
बस बस दैट्स इट दैट्स द ओनली लॉजिक टू दिस सो 24 एंड 12 इज 252 आई राइट डाउन द 25 220 वुड बी 40 0 एंड 16 वुड बी 16 दैट्स इट सो दैट्स हाउ आई डू माय कैलकुलेशंस एंड दिस इज अ स्मॉल एग्जांपल बट इफ आई हैव टू डू दिस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 8 द आंसर वुड बी 71634 70116258 and I literally did whatever I told you as quickly there. Nothing very different.
You did the same technique which was what you taught us right now.
Absolutely.
So which was 8 8 8 64 then 8 so 9 is 72.
Let's put this in Sagar's lingo. 64 takes 72. What is left?
हाँ, 7 को इधर धक्का मार के 71 कर दो.
So it's 712, right? 71 है. 2 takes 40. 60 is left, right? 0 takes 32. 3 is left. 2 takes 24. There's 4. 4 takes 56. There's 9. There's 6 and 48 now. Unfortunately, this will make this 50, because now this is where it will come to, and this is where there will be an issue, because 96 has to take 40.
But then this has to change to 5.
Which means it's about how much you can look ahead. Does that make sense?
Right.
It actually encourages you to think ahead. When I say it, the answer is 716350123166.
But you could also say 4 and then you'll have to go back.
Yeah, you have to go back, which is why after a certain amount of training, you sort of look ahead directly, which is like, oh, okay, 496. Acha, 5 lagne wala hai. So I'll put a 5 here and go for. This works because of how math works, distributive property and everything else.
Okay.
But this optimizes the amount of, numbers you hold per every time, which is, if I break this down between a regular calculation and whatever I do, and if this can be implemented, at any given point of time in the entire calculation, I'm not holding more than 2 digits. I'm holding less than 2 digits in my mind, but it's just that it's articulately put so that you don't have to remember anything more than that ever, because you cannot, as an individual, do remember more.
You cannot remember more than 2 digits, yeah?
No, you can do 3-4, but it's not the most optimal way.
Okay.
You want to give one a try?
Yes, I want to, but I cannot do it so fast.
That's okay.
But okay, Biswa yeah. Also maybe.
Biswa, let's try doing. I'm gonna make a few things look a little simple. Now let's try.
हाँ ठीक है. So 35 और 4 को उधर धक्का मार दो तो 39.
भाई दिमाग में कर सकते हो. दिमाग में कर सकते हो. बाकी लोग भी कर ले इधर.
Actually let's take Biswa first and then let's go to Sagar from Madurwa.
हाँ ठीक है.
Okay. Go ahead. I will take a while. 3 9 4 3-4, I feel.
Absolutely, that's correct.
Oh man, Biswa.
Not really. I'm going to encourage you. But
2-2-2-2.
So, Biswa, whenever you're saying one number, forget it.
Yeah, I had forgotten everything last minute.
That's the idea. It's LIFO, last and first
hour.
You do that. So, Sagar, let's try doing one more. Let's see. 8 7 4 3 into 4.
Okay. 28 34. 8 baki hai. Aur 8 aur fir 16. 8 bacha hai. 2 सिक्स है उधर और थ्री टू फोर 12 हो जाएगा 7-2.
एब्सोल्युटली दैट इज करेक्ट.
अबे मैं तो ये आंसर आने के बाद भी बिलीव नहीं होता कि ऐसा ये राइट रहेगा.
दिस इज करेक्ट, दिस इज करेक्ट. एंड एज यू सी राइट दिस विल फ्लो वेरी नेचुरली. लाइक वंस यू सॉर्ट ऑफ लेट्स से टेल योरसेल्फ कि अच्छा दिस इज व्हाट आई एम डूइंग इंस्टेड ऑफ लेट्स से सेइंग कि अच्छा मैं 32000 कर रहा हूं 2800 34800 160 12 व्हिच इज आई थिंक हाउ अ कंप्यूटर वुड डू इट वी कैन डू बेटर. या this is a little bit, I mean, jo kar sakte hain.
I'm just thinking in my day-to-day life, where do I use maths? Usually I use maths when I go to a restaurant and when someone is ordering, I'm like, bill kitna aayega? I'm just, so fatafat dekhta hu. So,
this then, only works if you order the same dish four times.
Into four.
Otherwise it doesn't work.
Yeah, yeah. This doesn't work there. That's just why, I think I'll actually, share one more thing here. Actually, मैंने stop किया. Sagar, I'm gonna share one more thing.
हाँ, you share. हाँ.
You can put this.
Okay.
This one here's a small challenge. ठीक है. Small challenge. it's only addition.
Okay.
Short up one digit. One digit addition. Okay. That's pretty much it. All right. I'm gonna put 10 numbers. And they're going to come in the span of 1 second each. With the
Bhai sir. Okay. Yeah. 1 second, hold on.
Let's start at 5.
Hey, hold on to that. Need to be ready for this.
Yes. Sagar, okay. You also should try this.
Okay, but I think Biswa will go first, no?
No, you can go both, go together.
Okay.
Yeah, let's see. 3, 2, 1 and go.
6, 9, 15.
ठीक है, इजी, या, ठीक है, द वार्म अप हो गया, नाउ आई पुट यू थ्रू, यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाट दिस इज, नो,
हे मैन, दैट्स नॉट फेयर, आई थॉट दैट्स द होल गेम, नाउ दिस इज द वार्म अप,
ये मेरे को क्यों ऐसे लग रहा है पता कि ये जमेगा, वो जब इस्त्री वाला आता है ना वो पर डे क्लोथ्स का ये तभी दिस इज
समथिंग नाउ दिस व्हाट यू हैव हियर इज अ वेरी गुड टेस्ट फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग हाउ प्रेजेंट यू आर इन द मोमेंट
ओके
इट्स अबाउट इट्स शेयर अमाउंट ऑफ लेट्स से मैं ये आई कैन सी ऑल द नंबर्स बिकॉज़ योर विजुअल सेंस इज इवैल्यूएटेड एट द सेम टाइम यू आर सपोज्ड टू ऐड ऑल ऑफ देम एंड वो आके चले जा रही है सो देयर इज नो वे यू रिमेंबर इट ठीक है सो आई एम गोना स्टार्ट गो That's the only thing which I'll show and then I'll show you what I do. Now look at it, it's the same thing, but it's two digits.
Are yaar 107 plus 44, 151 plus 167.
165 hai, you always Achha. Were correct. Last wala number 14 tha.
Oh, but I thought 16. Huh.
Yeah, but you see the complexity increases significantly when you make the change the digit. Because जब हम बच्चे थे हमको ऐसे ऐसे करवा रहे थे ना मैथ्स में 23, 36, 42 तो यू डू दिस फर्स्ट एंड देन यू डू दिस बट यू कांट डू दैट हियर बिकॉज़ द नंबर्स आर गोइंग अवे
करेक्ट
है ना तो दिस टेस्ट्स हाउ मच कैन यू होल्ड टू बिट्स ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एट द सेम टाइम नाउ आई होल्ड अ वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड फॉर दिस इन दिस एंड आई एम गोना शो यू दिस शॉर्टली एंड माय टाइम इंटरवल इज 0.3 सेकंड्स इट्स नॉट 1 सेकंड Okay, I'm going to try doing this. 19, 94, 186, 254, 349, 397, 414, 434, 523, 557.
Bye.
Wow.
Amazing. Too good.
And
this is like some kind of meditative state, right? You are in like you are very alert.
you're very alert and it's not like okay so I did a lot of these and then I realized ki iska point kya hai theek hai na kar rahe hai theek hai present hai what else and then I started to talk while I did this calculation and saw if this is something which I could manage and I practiced for it for like a lot of time and it actually works. अरे आई मिस्ड इट दिस टाइम
ओह 900 ठीक है वन से ही हुआ
इट डज वर्क
बट भानु वो ओपनिंग में e4 के जगह तुम बिशप g5 खेलते थे ना तो
रुको आई वांट टू let's do this again while we talk about something that requires more attention
we need him to answer also भानु you need to answer हां
ठीक है करेंगे I'll चलो
करते हैं।
चलो
आज क्या खाया भानु लंच में
राजमा चावल
कैसा लगा
बहुत अच्छा था
अच्छा खाना मतलब
6-1-5
देखो सवाल भी नहीं सोच रहा था क्या पूछूं उसको कैलकुलेट भी कर रहा
नाउ अभी इसमें ना ये जो है एंड इनफैक्ट आई हैव एक्चुअली डन वन ऑफ दीस प्रेजेंटेशंस रिसेंटली जहां I do this for the entire 10 minutes while I give the speech.
Wow.
So the idea here is, and again, I'm going to break it down, not for just saying that acha ye kar sakta hu and stuff, is that in under 5 to 6 days, people can achieve and do calculations like at least at this level. And this is something which I've seen. In under 5 days, we've seen people do this, what you're seeing right now.
Hmm.
Which this looks like a doable. Lot of effort.
This seems doable, but yeah, it's tough.
And if I make this even the question becomes harder, the deeper it gets, which is now, if
correct.
You see.
Correct.
So if someone can handle this for 30 seconds, it's enough brain exercise for mathematical skill of that day.
True.
That's the logic,
True.
Which is,
True.
And the only way you do this is by changing some fundamental thought process towards this.
I will tell you, like, when it comes to chess calculation, I mean Biswa can say it more precisely because he went through this process of being a core beginner to now being a good player. So jo calculation aap shuru mein kar rahe the, did it feel similar to this, like chess calculation and this?
Not
definitely
not this though, but for me it was I think for the other one, which is when I was doing the multiplication. And again, I've shown you only single digits, right?
Mm.
So if I do a multiplication of a 20-digit number with a 20-digit number, I'm thinking ahead by 8 turns in calculation already. So it sort of helps me in chess for sure. I mean, at least in the pace-wise, it does.
Mm.
I mean, even if I don't know the fundamentals. So the thinking ahead thing is, I think in chess, it's more two-dimensional. In calculation, sometimes it's single dimensional, but there's a lot which there is. For instance, if I'm doing a question like 783 multiplied by 825, then I'm thinking about six places which I need to fill. And I start with one, which is very easy. The last is very easy. The middle four are very hard. And I think Biswa would agree with this. The first and the last are very easy to get of any calculation. The middle ones are hard. So you have to guess ahead to do it. And yeah, okay. Chess seems very similar in that aspect.
Awesome, amazing. I want to ask Bhanu to do something spectacular. ऐसा कुछ और क्या कर सकते हो?
मेरे घर पे ना one of my play cousins plays chess. So he was like, let's play chess, but you do calculations while you do this. So he put like this and he was like, calculation थोड़ा slow लगाऊंगा, पर करते रहो and play this. Let's see how.
So how many thousand numbers or something? Yeah, pura game to bahut lamba chalega.
No, but it will stop like 10 seconds. It will stop 10 seconds again. So it keeps continuing like this. For instance, something like say this. Abhi main baat kar raha hu, ye ho raha hai. It will keep happening and I'll talk to you. And yeah, 666 and then I continue. So 568, I think I missed something. But yeah, it continues and goes on.
Biswa, so, if you can do this plus play blindfold chess, epic.
Mm-hmm. yeah. What else? What else? करते करते बाइक भी चला लूं एक हाथ छोड़ के. गाना गाते गाते
also blindfold is something which I always wanted to try chess mein acche se properly but I mean kyunki na I was like coordinate geometry theek hai to the knight will go plus 2 plus letter minus 2 minus letter minus 2 letters plus 1 all the logical combinations from a square kaise ho sakta hai so in the two coordinates it's plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 minus 1 plus or minus 2 plus or minus 1 wohi hai na
I have only felt like blindfold you cannot play by these calculations of like ki bishop ye hai to ye diagonal aisa jayega plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 letter add karo it's more like visual so you need to know
ki
ha to pura board
should actually
pakad hona chahiye
actually sagar remember one time you made all three of us do some puzzles that had like four pieces on the board then you call them out try one no it'll be very interesting for him also like a very simple one okay. nothing too fancy
okay so
it's very fascinating to solve
okay here is a puzzle white king there are only four pieces okay white king is on g1 white rook is on f1 black king is on e8
okay
and black bishop is on e5
okay
so white to play what will you play here
okay so it's f1 king g1 rook for white e8 king and e5 bishop
g1 king no
ha king g1 white ka white rook on f1 black king on e8 and bishop on e5
white to play is it
yes white to play and win the game basically when a bishop is facing a rook it's a draw like on a bare board but ye wale position mein white wins because of a very specific move which you have to play here if you don't play that you can't win iswa tumko aaya
yeah
okay I think I'm
no you, once you visualize you'll get it like instantly once you
it's
visualize
it's difficult
it,
to visualize the board no right now 64 squares how is it
yeah usually mera brain bol raha hai ki optimize karo pura yaad mat karo wahi problem hai bolta
your brain can see only those four squares
ha wo mostly the ha e f k k e 5 I don't think I should move the king it's white to play right
yes.
white to play so
but you can see this entire
see yes.
position like king kidhar hai rook kidhar hai black ka
yes.
king kidhar hai bishop
yes yeah I mean if I'm not getting the answer not evidently though so
does this help you look
just show the board not the pieces
I was thinking of the same no I think
did you see it
yeah
is that the image in your head
oh yeah that was yeah, I should have just logged it theek hai yeah
so,
it's rook one
exactly okay.
very nice no this is like a fascinating exercise for the brain
no I think I should let's do this
yeah
bro next time he'll come he'll be a grandmaster and all I am not playing with him
no nothing like that
you have to call some Kasparov or some Anand or Kramnik this guy is beyond control he's out of control man
I hope it worked in anything more than math though sometimes I mean in a few ways
one last thing I want to do Biswa is that you know what happens is if you take a two digit number theek hai koi bhi and you give it to him this is what I saw on YouTube and I was shocked yeah shocked matlab he doubles it theek hai and
no,
within
multiples
ha sorry multiples of that and within 30 seconds or 30 seconds right
15
seconds how many times can you do the multiples
ek so, guess before how much is it possible
jaise agar humne if you give him 88 to how many times can you do the multiples in 15 seconds aapke hisab se kitni bar hoga
I'm going to say
okay.
all of the results out loud
got it okay so I think 5 I'm going to be conservative here 5 I'm being too harsh maybe with 5 because it's like the no, it exponentially it increases very hard
okay let me do this one you can do a count okay 88 176, 264, 352, 440.
Oh, like that. I thought you'll multiply 88 with 88, with 88. Okay, got it.
Whoa. That one's very complicated. I think 6, 7 se zyada nahi hoga. But
got
sure,
it.
Let's look at addition multiples one.
Okay, got it. So you'll you'll do the table of that, right?
So it can even have a base, and it can be an AP also, basically.
Got it. Okay, cool. So I think then you can go up till 50. Too harsh?
too harsh, but world record, it's around though. Okay, let's try. And also one very fascinating thing is that when you count time, it actually feels more long if you see. I mean, that's something called the time paradox. Usually sometimes when I do calculations, I count time so that time feels longer, so you do more calculations. Anyway,
wow.
that's another discussion, but let's take a number, Biswa. Any two-digit number.
Okay. So, Sagar bhai, ready?
Haan, main idhar timer shuru kar raha hu.
Okay.
Aap ek second, number bolna mat. Then he will get to know, then wo pura calculate kar lega mind.
I wish memory se zyada calculation speed hai na. Memory wouldn't matter.
Nahin, you just, haan, okay.
Okay, 73.
73, 146, 218, 292, 363, 438, 521, 584, 657, 730, 803, 876, 941, 1022, 1095, 1168, 1241, 1314, 1318, 1462, 153, 1606, 167, 1752, 1825, 1898, 1979, 2044, 2117, 2190, 2263, 236, 241, 09, 248, 2555.
Metro caller karke batata hun, ek second.
What was it? The last was 2522 something, no?
2555.
2555. So that is
35 times. 35 times.
Wow.
I hold the record for 43 times, by the way. So,
wow.
Yeah. 43. And if you break it down, it comes to around 12 number calculations per second. Because there's two numbers you need to visualize, two numbers you need to add. There's one intermediate carry, so there's 5 into 2, 10 per second.
Bro, you're giving... like God, no? He gives something, then takes something. You're able to remember so much and do so much maths. What do you forget? That's all I want to know.
Oh, I forget everything. My memory is not great. Something which I wanted to tell before, math and memory have nothing to do with each other. If you've seen, I'm a good mathematician because I don't remember. Because because it doesn't work both ways. So, I mean, I forget everything. So it's fine. I mean, I'm a classic example of, let's say, RAM zyada hai, hard disk nahi hai.
So what you're saying is that when you're doing this, you're... how do you call it? The cache memory is doing all the work, right? But the long-term memory, that is normal like anyone else.
Absolutely. I mean, that's not something which I was really interested to develop. Bahut log hai aise bhi bahut, they do a bunch of other stuff. But long-term memory is more about giving that time, etching it in, sinking it in. It's stuff like that. Here, it's about what do you get in. So, abhi, it's like, 10 logon ko bulao, cricket khelo, bhej do. Ghar nahi hai.
Got it. Very nice. One day you'll forget that you hold records, then what? Then you'll like, I used to have something, man, I don't know. Something was there. Oh yes, Guinness World Records.
But this I've also seen of chess players, like if you tell, let's say, a very strong grandmaster, sometimes like Ivan Chuk, Anand, all these great players, they will say they remember 10,000 chess games. And everyone thinks, what a memory, yeah? Like amazing. Kuch bhi game bolo, in 1994 you played with this guy, they will tell all the moves. But then you ask them what happened like 2 days ago, they will not. So basically the chess memory is different from the other normal.
Yeah, one. Yeah. Just hold on for 1 minute. I'll check if somebody is there, then I'll bring them on screen. Let's just check.
Kisko? Acha. Bhanu, do you have a question, an interesting one for our viewers, which they can think over and then write in the comments and then we can discuss in the next session?
Yeah, I think one very good question which I have for everywhere I go standardly is, why does the number 10 come after 9? Right? The number 10 come after 9. Is there an alternate way where I say that the number 10 does not come after 9? And can you create a new system like that and do maths in it? It's like it's like playing a variation of chess. So
you mean not normal chess, but something like chess 960 type?
Absolutely.
So you have the nine numbers same, 1 to 9.
Hi, hello.
Hello.
Can you guys hear me?
Hi.
Yeah, this is my sister-in-law, Smrutika.
Hi.
Hi, Smrutika.
Yeah.
Hi.
And one second. She can't hear you. I'll just... Okay, now she can hear you, but there'll be a little bit of echo.
Actually,
chala gaya. So, she hates maths. Okay.
Maths hates me.
And, okay, one second. I'll just do echo cancellation. Yeah, she hates maths and she hates like all types of calculations. So you ask anything to Bhanu. Bhanu is the record holder for the human calculator.
Oh my god.
I just want to see your reaction. Sorry, Bhanu.
No. I was like, theek hai, wo Shakuntala Devi types. Wo wala.
Yeah, Shakuntala Devi record holder. But
I don't even like, my maths is not even good enough to ask the right question, just for context.
No, he'll help you. Bhanu, you can tell her to ask anything and she'll ask you.
I'll probably not understand that either, but...
Okay, maybe.
Like, very, like, normal, basic...
kuch bhi pooch. Basic is good, yes. We are all, Smrutika, we are all like you only, so...
Oh, no. After that, you should ask me to see how terrible I am. Nobody's, very few people are like me.
Let's okay. see, so...
But I need a calculator to verify.
I'll give
you
a calculator.
Calculator
hai idhar. So Biswa, you can take any 3-digit number. Do not tell me what it is. Okay?
Okay.
Do not tell me what it is. Just put it in your calculator. Yeah?
Okay.
Multiply it with the same number again.
Arey, Bhanu, abhi tum magic bhi karoge.
Multiply it with the same number again.
Okay, this is already making my armpit sweat.
Yeah, just tell me the number.
I have to do once. What is this?
No, just say the number like 8763.
Okay. Yeah, because I have to do.
That's okay. That's fine.
34645976.
Okay, the number with which you started was 326.
My God.
Please. Exit stays left.
That's the cube root of the number. Yeah.
Anna, why would you do that?
Oh, God. Now you should ask me something, but don't.
Won't do it today, so it's fine. Yeah.
I'm genuinely sweating just because I have to type that number and use a calculator. But.
But we have been with him for 1.5 hours now, we have never felt like, arre, but actually it has widened our horizons, ki hum ye bhi kar sakte. Like, until now, I was like, ye nahi, ho hi nahi sakta. How, why should, no one can do it.
It'll be the same reaction when I do maths, but just the day round. Ye toh ho hi nahi sakta. But, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye. Arey, I forgot to ask her, does she like chess or not?
I tried learning once.
She tried learning once.
I will continue.
Hmm. She would love to continue, but I'll bring her till 600 level and then you take over.
No, you only teach her.
Okay.
Wow.
But she's really amazed by this. The thing is, she has a fear of maths, so I've been working with her, like, she hates fractions and everything. So I've been trying to, like, work with her. She loves Italian food and stuff, so I tried explaining fractions with, like pizza and this thing. And now she's able to grasp, so she's quite excited about mathematics finally. And this was, I think this would help her a lot. Like, she would come and eat my head, how he did it. I don't know the answer, but that'll get a curiosity started, so that's great.
And also, Sagar and Biswa, there's a bunch of concepts which in math, which people don't really get a heck of why they exist, right? I mean, there are a bunch of things. I mean, in a general audience.
Ooh.
So, I was
Just one thing, Bhanu, I just have to break you here. I got to know in the chat, there is Temur Rajabo who's watching this. And Rajabo is world number 10 in chess. And he is one of the finest players in the world.
Hello. I've heard of him, yes.
You have heard of him?
I've heard of him, yes.
Fantastic. I mean, he's one of the best. And thank you. He says Sagar is genius, such a great work for the sake of the game. Thank you, Temur, for joining. That's very nice. Maybe one day if Temur is keen on learning some maths, I will get him and he can.
Absolutely.
Because he is also very good at calculations. I know that. Yeah, go on, Bhanu. Sorry to break you.
No, so I mean, thanks a lot first for Temur to come in. What I was telling was that so there's a lot of concepts, like Biswa would agree, irrational numbers. Isko feel koi nahi karta ki hai kya ye? Why do they exist? Ki kya hai? So I was actually thinking on doing a couple of random streams around irrational numbers. So I'll actually invite you there.
Oh, awesome. I did one and my favorite trivia is, you know, the A4 size paper. The ratio is 1:2.
Yes, it is. I know.
It's mind-blowing for me.
And also one more thing, which I think one thing which I mean, golden ratio to standard hai. Sabko pata hai ki kya cheeze hai, kya karte hai and all that. But I was actually studying something around finding irrational numbers. And there are two types of them. Do you know that?
I think I've heard of them.
One are plottable, the other are not plottable.
Yeah.
So it's like, this is what I tell people across jo mere classes mein bhi join hota hai, is that real number line hai. Numbers jo aage dikh rahe hai na, PUBG mein bahar aake aise kar rahe hai, unko shoot kar rahe hai, aise wale. There are irrational numbers which you can still spot, jo achhe hai, peeche khade hai. And there are some things which are invisible. So those are, I think, the really, really interesting ones. You can never plot them. So it's been proven that you can never position them on the line. So,
wow. Like, it's mathematically you can't plot them or just geometrically?
Geometrically you can't plot them. Mathematically also you can only go nearer the interval wise, but you can never find an algorithm which plots it.
Wow.
So yeah, I mean, that's interesting because they use it in encryption key systems.
Oh.
Unplottable irrationals instead of plottable ones.
By the way, Biswa is given a question for homework. To people in the chat, and also you can think about it. He said that 1 to 9 to rehta hai, but 9 ke baad, why do we have 10? Can we develop a system where there is no 10 and there is something else that comes after it and it makes sense, right? This is the question.
Basically, hexadec, binary, think in that lines, but in a way that you can try doing these mental additions in the mind. Does that make sense? Which is, if I say, if I say heptadecimal system hai, 3+4, so 10 is not the natural thing I get in my answers, right? How does one develop that is the question. Just saying that, give it a try. So yeah.
Got it. Okay. Very, very interesting question. Also, Sagar bhai, kyun aisa mere ko maths mein karta hoon karke idhar aap maths kara diye? I think we need to play another match, Bhanu. We need to play a proper match. ये मैं तो ऐसे ही आ गया था, मेरे को कुछ भी बोल दिया 1100 rating ये वो करके ऐसे ही मेरे को बिठा दिया. But next time we'll play it properly. You come on my stream. We'll do some maths and we'll do some chess. And yeah, enjoyable. उधर हम सागर भाई को नहीं बुलाएंगे, मजे करेंगे.
मैं प्रेशर डालता हूँ. बाय द वे, आई हैव टू टेल पीपल दैट देयर इज वन थिंग दैट चेस हैज ब्रॉट इनटू, सॉरी, मैथ्स हैज ब्रॉट इनटू चेस, और एस्पेशली इंडियन प्लेयर्स, बिकॉज जब बचपन में वी लर्नड मल्टीपल मल्टीप्लीकेशन, तो वो जो एक्स जो साइन रहता है उसको हम इनटू बोलते हैं, लाइक मल्टीप्लीकेशन में 5 × 6 वगैरह. सो यू विल गो एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड एंड इन चेस, यू नो, व्हेन यू कैप्चर अ पीस, it says Knight × E5, like Knight × E5. So pure world mein no country ke players say into, sim Indian players, everyone says Knight takes E5, but Indian players will say Knight × E5 because of this match. I think that is the main reason.
Duniya mein aapko pata hai na, brinjal ko brinjal khali hum hi log bolte hain.
Eggplant. Lady finger bhi hui hai.
अरे इंडिया में पब्लिक ब्रिंजॉल का,
ब्रिंजॉल से कितना ऐसा लगता है वर्ल्डली, पूरे मैन इट्स यूज्ड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड, ऐसा इट लुक्स,
सब जगह एग प्लांट बोलते हैं.
सेम थिंग विद कस्टर्ड एप्पल,
अच्छा
कस्टर्ड एप्पल इज आरपी चोक आउटसाइड इट्स नॉट कस्टर्ड एप्पल बट हां थैंक्स टू फार्म बिल बच्चा था ना जब सी थी पूरा लॉन्ग टाइम अगो
बट कूल ग्रेट थैंक यू बिस्वा फॉर कमिंग एंड एंजॉयिंग दिस विथ यू अराउंड चेस एंड मैथ्स बोथ आर फन सो मजा आया And Bhanu, of course, this is great to know you. We had been trying to, you know, do this for quite some time. I'm glad that we could make this happen. And you will go on Biswa's stream soon and you will also come here again. And I think your relation to chess would only intensify further. And the relation of people who have been learning chess, I think would welcome this association with maths as well. So that's why... It's not mess, guys. It's match. Please keep in mind it.
No, now it makes sense. Now it makes sense after this thing. Because how you're doing 24 plus 1 like that. So it's math, but last kind of TH, wahan pe chess replace ho raha hai.
So chess, it's yeah. The other one. Yes.
So it works. It works. Match works.
Yeah, looking forward, Sagar and Biswa, for more streams on chess and stuff otherwise.
मुझे नहीं समझा सो आई जस्ट सेड इट एंड
वो सेंटेंस में एक्स्ट्रा वर्ड रखता ही नहीं है भाई हेलो हाय आई जस्ट वांट टू से कुछ नहीं भाई Theory of Relativity by Einstein. That's how it talks. Restaurant mein jata hai seedha. Rice, water, boil.
Eat, go. Leave.
All right, friends. Bye-bye. I have to go.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Yeah, bye.
Take care. Bye. Bye, Bhanu.
Bye. Bye-bye. See you, Sagar.
See you.
Yeah, bye. I'll hit you up later. Bye-bye.
So, guys, in the chat, I hope you enjoyed this session. You know, in the chess world, I've always tried to kind of integrate as much as we can chess with other things because, you know, I feel that once you learn chess, there are other things, it's like a synergy, somehow I felt that, you know, today learning maths here, it felt really cool. And I hope that you also appreciate this fact that you can learn several things on this channel as well as through these streams. A big thanks to Bhanu for doing this. Please do subscribe to his channel, it's in the description. I couldn't link Biswa's channel somehow, but also go and follow Biswa, you know, he will do more streams now. His channel was kind of dormant for all this while, but now he's going to do more stuff on maths. There's Biswa Maths Aadmi. And who else, how do you find this, guys? Just let us know in the chat. Prathamesh says, loved it. OP stream. Nice. And guys, did you enjoy it? Commerce B. Alan Serrao says, very interesting. Okay, fantastic. Ilian says, loved it. Nice. Aha, Samay at 599k. Guys, go and subscribe if you haven't. Make him reach 600k. Sahil Pathak, great initiative, Sagar. Okay, fantastic. Raja was in the chat. Thank you so much, Raja, if you are here. And guys, also, Raja has launched his own chess academy, chessstars.az. So please check that out. It's amazing what amount of learning you can get from world-class trainers and players. So please check. Captain America says, epic stream. Akshit Tupkar says, it was nice experience. Anirudh says, Masta Sagar bhai, amazing. I'm going to actually learn this multiplication at least. Keep on practicing. I'll show it to Amruta and try to learn this and become faster at it. I think that much I can learn today. Yes, Siddharth Singh Sagar, you uploaded Kid Trap again yesterday. It was there already a few weeks earlier. Can you believe it, guys? I actually thought it was not there. Okay. I uploaded it, I published it, then when I read one comment saying that it's the same trap, I said, no, it can't be, I don't remember. I went back and I saw I did the same things. I even showed the same examples. It was not there in my head. So it's like it was there in my subconscious mind. I recorded it. I published, of course, all the mustache and all was new, but the example and everything was the same, which kind of scares me, because if I can't remember this, I was like, oh my God. So yeah, I have to be a little bit careful, because this series has been going for 3 to 4 months. Sometimes you tend to forget. I'm just getting old. I can't believe it. That I showed the same example. I was like, Amruta, this was great. We recorded a great video. And then when someone commented, this is the same video, and put the link, I checked this. Everything was the same. Yeah, yeah. Ayush Sahai says, software names Bhanu used. I'll ask him. I think maybe he's built some kind of a software. We'll ask him next time about it. Forum says, loving this collab already. Chess with music is possible. I think so, because we have written, I think Amruta has a few favorite singers. One is Raghav Chaitanya, who we like a lot, and we thought could be a nice one. Then Pratik Kuhad is someone whom we like a lot and wanted to get. Yashraj Mukhate was someone whom we had actually written to and invited for Super Juniors Cup. At that point, he was busy, but maybe he will join. So I think this something chess plus music may happen. And Samay is in Kolkata playing under the Gariat flyover, and he's beating people in simultaneous. So you see, chess is like spreading everywhere. So nice to see that. And thank you everyone for playing chess and for supporting it. And once again, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow is Women's Day. I'm writing a very interesting article on it. In fact, just trying to bring forth something very interesting on Women's Day. And also will make some videos on it. Maybe not a stream, but day after tomorrow is a stream, which is a repertoire for white with 1d4. You're going to learn from a big expert. So stay tuned for that. And until then, guys, please like the stream. Please subscribe to Chessbase India if you haven't. And make sure that you follow all the action. Until then, bye-bye.